Hi, I'm Dan Zicko, a 3D art and motion director. Today, I'm going to show you how to encode your 3D animated designs for Vimeo and Instagram. So I'm going to bring the animations in just from my desktop, drag and drop them into the panel up here. So the first setting we're going to be using for the HD version is to create a version for Vimeo. So I like to use QuickTime and set it up for Apple ProRes 422 HQ. Then I'm going to set my output to my master folder, and I'm going to create a folder called animation. And I'll save this as HD Vimeo. And if I select into my Apple ProRes settings, can have a look what I've got here. So we don't need audio, so I'm just going to turn that off. And let's head into our video. So we've got ProRes 422 HQ. And you know, you can use ProRes or other settings, but quality, I like to keep things as high as possible. Also, depending on your allowance of how big the files are or how many files you can publish per month, take that into account, but I generally use ProRes 422 HQ for Vimeo. And I pretty much just keep everything else at a default. It says maximum render quality, let's do it. And the other thing you can do is set a preset. Now that we've got all that set up and we want to be able to render other things with the same preset, I'm just going to save this preset. So that's the first one set up for Vimeo. And this one is purely for Instagram because it's a square crop. So I'm going to go to H.264. Just select on my preset and have a look at what we've got. Got audio saved by default. I'm going to turn that off. The match source is set. So it's 1080 by 1080, which is our crop. I've got render at maximum depth turned on. And I've got the bitrate settings set to target to 25 and maximum bitrate 35. Because if it's too high or too low, it kind of plays a bit differently on Instagram. You use maximum render quality set to on, and you've got an estimated file size here as well that will allow you to work out if it's too big or small for whatever you're posting to. So I'm just going to press OK. And now I'm just going to press play and start the queue. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to this channel. If you want to learn more about me and my process, check out my online course on Domestika.